So we're ready to hear the presentation by Professor Andy Gomula. Which is your university, sir?
Excuse me?
Which is your university?
My university, it was also a medical academy.
Yeah.
University.
Anyway, he's one of these maverick urologists who dare to use hCG preparations. Say hCG because you can go to jail for using testosterone, I believe, in Poland, because they're against anything that will reduce a man's fertility. It's illegal. So he's cleverly got around that and has many years' experience that I'd like him to share with us in hCG treatment. Thank you, Andy.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, it's a great honor and pleasure that I can present to you the latest ideas about aging men's hormone therapy. At the beginning, the science on testosterone deficit was a great chaos. No one knew how to call this problem. Testosterone deficiency was known as ADEM. But the question is, whether this applies to the elderly or adult men, because it's a big difference. Testosterone deficiency is called PEDAM, but what does it mean? Is it possible to have partial overdraft in the bun? Is it possible to be partially pregnant? To this day, there is nowhere to put a good standard of the zero where counting of the deficit should be started. Late onset hypogonadism and testosterone deficiency syndrome terms are used interchangeably. I believe that these terms should not substitute each other. Late onset hypogonadism should not be substituted. Look, it is disease and testosterone deficit which increases with age, and testosterone deficiency syndrome, it is clinical consequences of testosterone deficit. Next question, what type of hypogonadism is the late onset hypogonadism? According to the scientific basis in this field of endocrinology, hypogonadotropic hypogonadism is diagnosed if after hCG administration, testosterone levels doubled. What were the results of hCG tests in 1,500 hypogonadal men? On average, testosterone level more than doubled, and it is in all age group from 20 to 90. This means that late onset hypogonadism, it is classic hypogonadotropic hypogonadism. And in accordance with the principles of endocrinology, hypogonadotropic hypogonadism should be treated but by administering hCG. Until now, it was believed that low testosterone level in aging men is associated with lady cells insufficiency. And for this reason, testosterone was used in the treatment of hypogonadal men. Relying in the views that primary testicular failure comes with age is a fundamental mistake. The effectiveness of endosynthesis persists into old age. Chances for men and women in the hormonal therapy are not equal. According to the recommendation of World Health Organization, a woman should start hormone therapy early enough to avoid dangerous, irreversible anatomical changes. And what about men? Men has the highest level of testosterone about 30 years of age, after which the testosterone level keep decreasing for many years. And now the question, when should a man begin hormone therapy? Indications for hormonal therapy for men repeatedly changed. At the beginning, it was believed that the therapy should be initiated at a concentration of testosterone below 8 nanomol. After them, the lowest standard was elevated to 12. But look, all the times, 8 and 12, and mean testosterone level in different age group is higher than standard. What does it mean? The standard is not good or is not such illness as testosterone deficiency. The standard given by Professor Runefeld during the Moscow 7th International ISAM Congress also seems too low. Now the standard is 15. Too low. The standard will change again, but they still did not fit to the reality. Either such a disease as testosterone deficiency does not exist in any age group, or the standards have been changed again. It's too late to introduce therapy when testosterone level is below 15 nanomol per liter. The clinical effect during therapy with synthetic testosterone, when its level reached to 20-25 nanomol, are minimal. When synthetic testosterone is used, its level will be proportional to the dose applied. When hCG is used, testosterone level will reflect the physiological capabilities of the organism. What are the clinical effects when testosterone level increase from 18 to 39 nanomol? And now the effects of hCG therapy in late onset hypogonadism. I will begin to present the most spectacular effects of hCG therapy in my experience.
Before I started being treated hormonally, I was stupefied and sluggish. Since the beginning of the treatment, my condition has improved markedly. Now I feel like working and socializing, which I avoided before. I also move much easier. Passing water has improved too. Hand tremor has relieved also.
What terrified me most was that my husband kept losing his balance. Hormonal treatment improves that clearly. When the hormonal therapy was stopped, the condition got worse. I believe that my husband's hormonal therapy is what does him really good.
I'm 81 years old and have suffered from Parkinson's disease for 21 years. In the last 4 years, I have been treated hormonally, which has improved my condition substantially. All unwanted manifestations have disappeared.
Since my husband started to take hormonal therapy, his condition and behavior have improved markedly. Now my husband can walk and shave by himself. Before that, I had to help him shave because of the tremor in his hand. Now this tremor has disappeared completely. Such an improvement is a great relief for me too, because my husband has pulled himself together and is back to his normal life activity.
Dear colleagues, there were the words, but now the facts.
The biggest problem for Parkinsonism patients is their slowness and motor insufficiency. They have to depend on other people's help, plus the troublesome limb tremor. Lying down on a couch creates no problem for a healthy person. It does for a Parkinsonism patient. But the real problem appears when a patient wants to get up. This patient was unable to get up by himself before the hormonal therapy was introduced. Here's the motor condition of the patient before the hormonal therapy, and now during the therapy. It is a completely different man. He also has much bigger possibilities. The hand tremor has relieved. What used to be unobtainable creates no problem owing to the hormonal therapy.
And now the question, what is the correlation between testosterone insulin, and diabetes type 2. With age, diabetes mellitus type 2 develops also the concentration with insulin increases. During hCG therapy, the metabolism rate increases along the increase in testosterone level. This result is faster burning of glucose and consequently lack of hyperglycemia. Glycated hemoglobin is significantly reduced, being 7.7 at pre-treatment by testosterone level 14 nanomole to 6.4, practically standard. During therapy, when testosterone level is 34. And now, effects of hCG therapy on lipid profile. The level of total cholesterol drops by 18%, triglycerides by 20, normalization of LDL and HDL. And now, does hCG therapy affects bone density? HCT therapy significantly restores bone calcification without additional therapy for osteoporosis. Densitometric comparison of the same patient before and after 13 months of treatment shows a clear reduction of risk for hip fracture. Before and now. Annual treatment with hCG increases by 8.4% the bone rate of calcification due to age, from 87 to 95. And this is the effect of long-term hCG treatment. A 62-year-old patient and bone density 92 for young and for age mate 118. This is the result of my own examination. Depression, biggest problem in the world. More than double increase in serum testosterone and estradiol caused the disappearance of depression and transition into the joy of life. With the help of Beck's test, it was demonstrated that depression pre-hormonal therapy, this all red bars, not only relented, but patient went into the area of joy of life. Here, this red, these green bars, both dopamine and estrogen derivative stimulates dopamine receptor in the brain. That is why estrogens are necessary not only for men, but for women too. This explains the cause of depression and Parkinsonism. And here is a key to dopamine receptors in the brain. My patients with Parkinson's disease, during therapy, when testosterone is too high during treatment of hCG and estradiol is not so high, I add extra estradiol, which is used in hormonal replacement in women. And what are the clinical consequences of hCG therapy for prostate? Dear colleagues, there are facts. And facts must not be disputed. They must be taken into consideration. The young man has high concentration on testosterone and at the same time, no PPH and no prostate cancer. For 40 years, it has been known that testosterone deficiency causes adenoma and carcinoma of prostate. Due to hormonal deficit, the transitional zone on prostate, here you have prostate, the bladder, and transitional zone of prostate increases consequently, and if it's deficit of testosterone, this zone is growing. In ultrasound examination, we find the prostate hypoechogenic area, a classic image of inflammation, and is described in ultrasound examination as inflammatory process. This is not inflammatory process. It is a result of testosterone deficit, and it is area where prostate is growing adenoma tissue as a result of deficit testosterone from testes. This can be seen in the transabdominal and transrectal studies presented the same, and for diagnosis of a testosterone deficit, a transrectal examination of ultrasound are not necessary. And here can be seen consequently phases of adenoma formation. Little adenoma, a little bigger, big adenoma, and after 3 to 5 years, hypogenic adenoma is like the prostate tissue. And what is the effect of hCG therapy on BPH? In MRI pictures, look, please, the markers, red and yellow, here and here are the same. But before therapy, the adenoma, and after 3 months of therapy, is big reduction of adenoma tissue. As you can see in MRI, after hCG treatment, the adenoma area is considerably smaller than before the treatment. Next patient, and adenoma of prostate in MRI. Before treatment, after 2 months, adenoma is smaller than. And here, adenoma of prostate before treatment, the same patient. Look, this is a failure in prostate. Here, 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 it is the same man. Before, after 3 months, and after 6 months, you can see here a reduction of volume of the adenoma of prostate. Finally, the problem of prostate cancer. Half a century ago, Higgins published the theory about the negative influence of testosterone on prostate cell. He stated that castration causes regression of prostate cancer, while testosterone results is in its progression. And for half a century, it was not possible to say that it is not the case, because he received the Nobel Prize for his theory. After years, it turned out that there is no scientific base for the claim that higher concentration of testosterone accelerates the development of prostate cancer, and Higgins' hypothesis was based on a misinterpretation and of observation of only one patient. The knowledge of testosterone prostate cancer correlation today looks like Titanic. We know that in patients with prostate cancer, there is a close correlation between testosterone deficiency and degree of malignancy of prostate cancer. The greater testosterone deficit is correlated with high malignancy in Gleason score. If testosterone level is higher, malignancy on prostate cancer is lower. So far, various publications have observed with satisfaction that during testosterone therapy, no significant increase in PSA is observed. And now, what to do when there is a rapid increase in PSA? Extended diagnosis to search a prostate cancer. And what to do if there was a sharp decline in PSA? This was not foreseen by scientists. And now the facts. This patient, by testosterone 4.3, PSA 2.2. Testosterone from 4 to 90, to 20 practically, and PSA 2.2, 0.5. Next one. By testosterone 16.8, PSA was 12. Testosterone 2, 78. PSA from 12 to 2.6. And look here. It is number of performed tests in this laboratory. 11,000, 12,000, but it was in year 2006. Now it's more than 20,000. And now, testosterone 71, PSA 41. Testosterone increase from 40, 20 times down. When prostate cancer grows, PSA increases. And when PSA falls, what happens with prostate cancer? Does this disappear? Testosterone does not increase PSA, and PSA is not a specific marker for prostate cancer. During hCG therapy, 1,500 men, mean follow-up, 37 months, PSA level decreased by 23%. And what is the correlation between the deficit of testosterone in PSA? PSA increases parallelly to the increase of deficit of testosterone. When ratio LH to testosterone increases, and this is indicator of testosterone deficiency, the same time increases PSA. Is correlation between PSA and testosterone, but not with testosterone level, only testosterone deficit. And testosterone deficit in different men is not at the same level. For one man, the testosterone deficit is by 10, 15, or 20, and at the second one, the same testosterone deficit can be by testosterone 40. The increase in testosterone endosynthesis is closely associated with the increase in the risk for prostate cancer. And now look, please. Ability of testosterone endosynthesis versus LH3 PSA ratio. If this ratio, LH to PSA, to 3 PSA, is low, in old age group, is high ability to endosynthesis. And now, the same age group, but this ratio is higher than here. And possibilities is practically two times lower of endosynthesis. It is 100%, and here 100% is by 80, but at a different index. What more? When I see this index, I know how are not only possibilities of endosynthesis, but how high is risk of prostate cancer. If this index here is 0.5, close the eye and perform biopsy. Without looking in different area of diagnosis as standard in prostate cancer. And now the discussion of ISAM recommendation. How to diagnose and treat late onset hypogonadism? And look please to this recommendation. Human hormone gonadotropin stimulates testosterone producing of the Leydig cells applied at the lower rate in older men in the younger men. Sorry, not true. In all age group, there is possibility to endosynthesis. It's lower in older men, but it is physiology. Testosterone endosynthesis with hCG therapy allows for an average of more than double increases in the total testosterone, 2.5 times increase in free testosterone, 2.5 times increase in bioavailable testosterone, and the sum concentration of hCGV, and 1.5 times reduction of total PSA. And now, what is it with testosterone level When you started, for example, giving testosterone by 12 nanomol, 6 months, 1 year, in this moment you stop the therapy. In this moment, testosterone level in this patient is about 0.6 nanomol, 8 nanomol, not higher. It is not logic. In this moment, when you started by 12, now is 6 or 8, there are now indications for testosterone treatment, and we stopped according to recommendation. And what is with testosterone level during hCG therapy, and when we stop this therapy, the testosterone drops and a little is going up. At about 70% of patients, after 1-2 year therapy, this testosterone level is 50 to 100% higher without stimulation of hCG. And I call this phenomenon androversion, coming to natural synthesis, like natural heart ratio pulse after the fibrillation, and is cardioversion. However, after stopping testosterone replacement therapy, level is lower than it was before the treatment, we stop this therapy. In accordance with the ISAM recommendation, hCG therapy is not recommended in late-onset hypogonadism, since insufficient information exists about the adverse effect of hCG treatment in older men. Dear colleagues, here you have a report of Polish FDA. In the last 70 years, has been not a single complication following the hCG therapy reported. It is a phenomenon on the global scale. And what complications does testosterone therapy give? And here is again the fundamental book of endocrinology. Androgens, administered both orally and intramuscularly, are used illegally in variation without rules of sports competition by some athletes to increase muscles, mass and strength. And the same has as side effects oligospermia, infertility, and testicular atrophy after testosterone treatment. And now is a question, and what is with men treated with testosterone? There are not athletes. The same results? Infertility and testicular atrophy? In my country, in Poland, under the law, someone who deprives a man of the ability to procreate is imprisoned for 1 to 10 years. That is why I use hCG in the treatment. And look here. The ISAM recommendation said that hCG therapy should not be applied except when fertility is in use. What does it mean? Look, the authors of ISAM recommendations are also the authors of the paper reporting the contraceptive action of testosterone. They know very well that testosterone destroyed the testes, but officially they are hiding it. When we have to choose natural or artificial honey, the choice is simple. Testosterone is the same. Testosterone naturally derived from endosynthesis stimulation by hCG and synthetic testosterone produce completely different clinical consequences. And now, will you please look at page 127, not in book, only in ISAM recommendations. You can read there that there is a financial conflict of interests. The author of recommendations are financed by pharmaceutical companies. Should the ISAM guidelines sponsored by pharmaceutical companies fought and harmful to men to be based for the treatment of men? Currently, we have an era of evidence-based medicine. Dear colleagues, What I have presented is supported by a lot of evidence. So much evidence, this cannot be stopped. It is like an avalanche which will sweep away the present point of view. The material includes more than 2,200 men investigated and more than 1,500 treated. I performed more than 20,000 laboratory tests. It was year 1996, the great revolution based on the state of medical knowledge. Malcolm, you put in a lot of trouble and you have achieved success. Congratulations. But currently, ISSAM expands its activities from the treatment of the elderly to taking care for young men. From marketing point of view, it wants to take over a new market. Our duty is to act for the good of patients and not against the patients. And as I have shown you, according to the principles of endocrinology, the administration of testosterone, especially to a young man, leads to infertility and irreversible testicular atrophy. And here is a question. Is the administration of testosterone to men who has the ability to synthesize his own testosterone beneficial or harmful? Is this not even medical malpractice? What you have been present is the base for a revolution in this field of hormone therapy in men of all ages. Currently, there is no doubt that we need to fundamentally change the point of view of both of diagnosis and hormone therapy for men. This new revolution has already begun. The current point of view can no longer defend itself. Should the Society of the Study of Androgen Deficiency be the first in the world to publish novel and appropriate guidelines on diagnosis and therapy on testosterone deficiency in men, I'm ready to share with you my knowledge and experience resulting from 30 years clinical experience. Thanks for attention.